I decided to make another little video here of the pump testing station and wanted to point out some things that can be kind of deceiving with other videos that you can see about pumps pumping way up high and then having the water come back down. What we have here is we got the 4-inch discharge line from the pump going into the tank, 90ing up, and the bottom of that horizontal piece is 85 inches above the water. It goes horizontal for 10 inches, and then it comes back down for 45 inches before the pipe opens up, and we get a nice solid stream of water coming out of there, so there's no air trapped inside that pipe. And what that does is it actually creates a siphon effect. The pump is having to pump the water up that 9 feet roughly, and then it comes back down. But as it comes down through that 45 inch pipe, gravity is helping to pull that water back down. So it's actually taking work away from the pump. So I just want to kind of run through here. We've got our ultrasonic flow meters that are measuring how much water is flowing. I went ahead and hooked up the used Artesian 2 half horsepower 76 that I have. We're at negative 0.3 feet of head pressure on the suction side and positive 10.8. It bounces up to 11 feet of head pressure on here. Our two flow meters. Right now we're at 610 watts or so at 118.7 volts. And then here you can stop the recording and look at the actual details there. I averaged the flow. So right now we're getting about 5275 gallons per hour out of this setup. So I'm gonna go ahead and climb up there. Hopefully I don't bust my butt and take that vertical piece of pipe out and see what happens to the numbers. So bear with me here. This is kind of a rickety setup. Last time I messed around with this, I knocked the whole unit over and had to start back again. So let's hope the second time is a charm here. Hopefully everything stays put. Come back out of here. Alright, so now we obviously have a crazy stream of water coming out of there now. No more siphoning effect of the water coming down. So I'm going to let the flow meters calibrate themselves here. They're slowly going to start going down. But one thing to show here is just by doing that, we are now at 14.25 feet of head pressure and still at the negative 0.3 feet of head pressure. So obviously that pipe was doing some kind of work if our head pressure actually went up after we removed that vertical piece. So another way of showing that is we are doing 586 watts of work right now. With centrifugal water pumps, the harder it is for the pump to, or the higher the pump pushes the water, the less wattage it actually uses because that impeller starts slipping. So now we're at 585 watts. That's still the 118. And let's look at our flow meters now. We're down at 4825 and 4745. Compared to our 5275. So just by having that vertical down tube on it, it gained us about an extra 1,000 gallons per hour or so of water that was flowing through there. So it's no longer a myth, guys, that having a vertical down tube on your pump actually takes some of the work away from it. So if you want to see a real video of what a pump can do, pumping water way up to a waterfall, that's how you rig it up. No vertical downpipe going back into the tank.